Biết biết.
Bao nhiêu?
Lạp ấy.
Bao nhiêu? 40 nhiêu nhỉ? Dạ.
Nhà bếp.
Nó nhà bếp. Ông
ta bán cơm cho cái này.
Ông đi đâu?
Mr. Ameya Pratap Singh, along with core team member Mr. Abhijit Deshmukh. So let's have a curtain roll now and let's invite these wonderful set of leaders right here, right now, to be part of this wonderful change. All right, so on that note, the curtain is officially open. That means it's time to march ahead with the next segment of the program. Ladies and gentlemen, on that note, we're truly delighted to have the presence of some of our finest dignitaries here who have not just come to support this wonderful change. First up, I'd like to invite Shri Kaiser Khalid. Let's have a huge round of applause to welcome our very own Shri Kaiser Khalid. I'm going to be requesting Ameya and Abhijit to also present the bouquet to Shri Kaiser Khalid for his valuable presence this afternoon. Request also Abhijit to please present the floral bouquet to welcome Dr. Sanjay Singh. Well, it's time to march ahead to some of the finest talents of our country. And when we talk about sports, well, it's up next to invite on stage our very own Indian professional snooker player and a very, very talented, gifted player. Please put your hands together for Aditya Mehta. In fact, in the year 2013, he became the first Indian to reach the final of a ranking tournament at his own home event, the Indian Open, and that truly, truly is inspiring. Very warm welcome, indeed. Ladies and gentlemen, let's march ahead, and it's truly an honor to invite. Well, that's right. As you can notice, he's also pretty young and dynamic. But the thing is about lawyer. That comes automatically for me, Shri. All right, a very warm welcome indeed to you as well. Well, we're talking about this young and dynamic lighting the screen in Calendar Girls, Madhur Bhandarkar's movie, and I'm sure she delighted us all. Let's also welcome her with a round of applause. Let's hear it for a very young and vivacious Avni Modi. All right, now, in fact, a couple of minutes ago, aap sabne shayad ye gana suna hoga, Sunona Sang Marmar. You know, I think when you hear the song, the first thing that you remember is this beautiful actress. I think I don't need to even invite or even introduce the name. To usse pehle hi taaliyan bajne lagi. Can we have a huge round cheer for the very beautiful and the very, very sweet Neha Sharmala. She's already smiling. I can't help it. I can see all you wonderful boys out there. Yes, I can see your smiles change. Superb. I totally, totally understand. Well, it's time for the girls to smile right now. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, I should admit one thing for sure. He's not just a popular actor, he's a thinking actor. And I think, iski jo jhalak hai, we got to see it right in his first debut movie called Amal. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for the very, very vivacious television host, Bollywood actor, and our very own Rajiv Khandelwal. Well, ladies and gentlemen, on that note, I think, please, superb. Rajiv, would it be appropriate if I can request you to please share your inputs first?
You know, I just walked in sadly late, not fashionably late. I generally got stuck in traffic, you know, Mumbai. To, you know, always get away with an excuse of saying that I was stuck in traffic. But I was actually stuck in traffic. But whatever I heard towards the end makes a lot of sense. A lot of sense to me because, you know, I was sitting here and I was, it actually took me back to my college years. And I was wondering, would these thoughts even cross our mind back in the day then? You know, I don't think that we ever thought of changing the country. We did have our own ambitions, we did have our own goals, but we never thought of bringing in a revolution. I think it was much smaller thinking, not because we weren't exposed. I think it was because there weren't too many avenues available. You know, when I went to my college in St. Xavier's, Ahmedabad, I remember life was all about hostel, college canteen, lab. I'm a science graduate, you know, labs, girls' hostel, you know. Chai ki dukaan galla, chai ka galla, maximum cinema halls, breaking some rules. That was it. And then towards the end, towards the final year, getting worried about your future. Now I see these guys talk, I mean, amazingly well. I mean, you just start wondering, man, tum log kab paida hue the, kab bade hue, aur itne smart, itne intelligent, kab ban gaye? But I think that is also the exposure. I mean, so much is happening around. We have, I mean, as youngsters, you have so many avenues, you have so many platforms, you have so much to do, you can do so much. I think when I was in college, I never thought that I can actually bring in a revolution. I can only maybe start something, I could do something. You know, there were times when we were bullied by seniors, by, you know, college presidents and all, and we didn't have ways and means to reach out. We didn't have ways and means to shake up the college management or the authorities or the government. Forget about the government. You know, we didn't have ways and means to even tell them that we are here and we have an issue, we wanted to reach out to you, but there weren't any ways besides the conventional ones. Now, sitting here, you know, you can bring in a change nationally, on a national scale, on an international scale. All you've got to do is just join hands, all you've got to do is just pick up the right platform and you can actually bring in the change. This country, I guess, today I think most of you must be knowing, you know, there's 65% youngsters. India is made of 65% youth, which means you guys actually rule without knowing that you guys are ruling. Whatever is happening in the country, be it any governments come, governments fall, any other things that are happening in this country, you guys are really instrumental. You probably would not be even knowing your strength, but you guys are really instrumental in bringing the change and in what the state of the country is. So all I say, with all the intelligence, with all the exposure, with all your sensibility, be aware of your responsibility. You know, you actually will have to be aware of your responsibility, because you can and you are the ones who will bring in the change in this country. So on that note, I'll let others also, you know, give their views of it. By the way, wonderful being here. And yeah, so whom do you want me to pass the mic to?
To share his perspectives as well.
While I was listening to Ameya and Rajiv and Abhishek, I remember my college days, the only time we had an opportunity to speak was in debates. There was nothing else. And there was no way you can express yourself differently. But today's youth, I see and I believe that they truly believe in this thing, that they can change the things for better. And that is how the whole civilization has progressed. We were hunter-gatherers at some point of time, we became agriculturists, we became industrial people, we became technological people and information age people. We have passed through a lot of phases of doing things. And I think that is what drives Ameya and his colleagues to establish such things, that a lot of energy, a guiding force and a source of power for the country to progress forward, move ahead. As it is, you know, the way we have progressed in the last 20-30 odd years, well, I see the change when you go to a foreign country and place, and a lot of confidence has come in the Indian population itself. So this is a time that we don't see their articles getting published in newspapers, we do not see them debating on TVs, so there has to be a platform where their voice comes forward and it is there to listen. And also it is always better to get a perspective which is fair. But today's youth has come up in a very different fashion. His evolution is different. We must have a
check on it.
To be honest, I look a lot younger than I am. So I don't know. You know, I'm a bit like, not exactly out of place, but my life has been so different. My life has been solitary, you know. I've gone after one thing in my life, and it's taken me away from school, from college, from studies, from friends, from everything. So when I get into a situation like this and I see the people around me with the ideas that they have, I feel like a fish out of water. So I don't know exactly what I have to give, but I think what I can say is that I took that path where I had to do something different. You know, I had this vision of doing something that in my sport nobody had ever done, was to go professional and go to England and play in a world where we were, you know, we had no chance. Nobody had ever succeeded. So in doing that, I thought maybe I would open up this avenue to the future of our, you know, of our country. I have failed a lot more than I have succeeded. That's exactly because I took that path. But I never regretted it, because I always told myself just that one thing, that, you know, just you have to start something here that the future will thrive on. So, you know, I took that path, and that is exactly, I think, what we're talking about. We're talking about starting something which will, you know, will lead to a more prosperous future and will lead to the youth of our nation actually succeeding at what they dreamt of doing, of what they really want to do. And so, I mean, even in my my brother-in-law helps me a lot with sort of, you know, promoting me, because obviously we all need a bit of promotion here and there. And one of the things that really stands out is the saying that, you know, two roads diverge in the woods, and I took the one less traveled by, and that has made all the difference. So I hope that, you know, like that, we can all take the road that people don't generally take. In India, we like to keep it safe, you know, we like to, you know, try and test it, keep the parents happy, but, you know, you're not really going to get anywhere like that. Not anything against the parents, of course. Everyone wants their children to succeed. So I just mean that, you know, if you have something, if you have a passion, don't be afraid to lose, and don't be afraid of failure, because, I mean, that's a lot more valuable than titles. And I think today, if I am where I am, then it's only because I took that path and I failed. And I'm very happy that I did that. So, I mean, I wish all the best to you guys for, you know, this initiative.
I'm super excited to be here. It's so nice to see all you guys here supporting this beautiful cause. And I hope college life is treating you guys well. I don't know, I can't really remember when I was into, you know, thinking what can I do for the country, or, you know, let's do something for the world. I mean, I was busy in my own life doing my own thing in college. I had no time to think about these things. So Abhishek and Amaya, you guys are doing a brilliant job here trying to think about a change, honestly. And when I was listening to them talk, I was like, you know, it's great that at least someone's trying to do something different and not busy in their own lives, because I think all of us are pretty much busy with what we are doing, and we think that is the whole world that we're living in, but there's so much more to actually do. So I want to wish you guys all the best for the initiative, and I hope that everybody who's here can participate and not be like a passive listener or viewer, and actively participate in this and try to bring a change. And I think that really works out well for everybody. Thank you, everybody.
Well, thank you very much, Neha. In fact, I think you were also part of the movie Youngestown, and that we totally love the concept and the way how the youth decided to, you know, address a very different topic altogether. So thank you so much again, Neha. Well, we're going to continue on that note, and I'm going to be asking the very beautiful Avni, of course, next. That's right. I'm going to request you also to share your inputs with this wonderful audience. Avni, over to you.
Hi everyone. First of all, I want all of you to give a big round of applause for Abhishek and Amaya. The guys who can actually think of creating a platform like Think Tank. You know, because as a youth, we have nothing to do except thinking. Because we don't earn money, and the only thing we do is spend from our pocket money. So we can just think how to grab pocket money, how to increase our money, and how to spend it. So to create this platform, Think Tank, it's an amazing thing. And actually, what I believe is that today's youth is divided in two generations. It's like few people who exactly know what they want to do in life, how they want to do in life, and the others who are clueless, who doesn't know what to do in life. So, ek kehte hai ki jo kuch nahi karte, wo kamal karte hain. You never know what they end up doing in life. You know, so I really respect those who doesn't have any idea about their future. If you just ask them that what are you going to do after your college, or they must be thinking of planning a trip to Goa. So I just salute you guys, just be the way you are, because you will end up doing the most important thing in your life. But those who actually know what they want to do and how they want to do, they have a lot many things to think. And when I was in my college, I had lot many options to pursue my career, but I wanted to be an actress and I really had no one to guide me. And but I just wanted to be in this industry, so I just kept going and I came to Mumbai and I started working here. But yeah, I wish I could have someone to guide me properly, where I can share my thoughts, where I can share my confusions, where I can share my problems. But that time, I in my college or in the place where I belong to, I didn't have anyone to guide me properly. But yes, I want to be in that place where I can guide others, where I can inspire others. So if I can be the part of this kind of platform, that it's an opportunity for me. That's a very big, it's a novel and social cause where I can be in that space where I can actually guide others. And the only thing which I want to say is that, you know, it's not important how the young generation thinks. It's also important how the elders who are going to actually allow them, you know, what they want to do. So it's very important how we convince our parents about our thoughts, about our future goals. Because we are trapped in a society where we are living in a rules and regulations, which is created by our elders, our parents and the society. So the think tank actually should think about the ideas of how to make a way in the, not just in the generation, young generation, but also the elder generation, who is actually going to permit us, who is actually going to give us the wings to fly. Thank you.
That you had a radically new perspective as well. It's about the elder in the think tank discussion. Rajiv, I don't want to disturb you because something that we're all excited about is your upcoming film Fever. And the concept about it is to do with the thrillers. That's right. Did I just take put you on the spot?
Tell me one thing. Was this question plugged by my PR guys?
No. Oh, is your PR here?
No, I don't see them, but I'm sure
that's
all
right.
Okay, I don't want to talk much about my film Fever, you know, they will get to see it in the due course of time. But yeah, so guys, my film is releasing next month, so I don't want to do this right now. Well, suddenly we are on different planes, so let's discuss more about the youth, guys. You know, it just doesn't fit in here, to be very honest.
Super, all right. So with your permission, then let me just march ahead and let's go to the serious set of discussions. On that note, ladies and gentlemen, time to check a little input from our ever-smiling lawyer over here. Yes, Sirji, let's have Mr. Srinivas Bobade share his answer.
My name is Srinivas Bobade. Being the lawyer on this panel, I guess I'm expected to talk about how law can bring about a social change. And actually, really like your initiative, because I think the two things that you're doing is tapping the youth, which, like you said, postgraduate people get to be a part of Think Tank, which is so unfair because the youth is not jaded and they're idealistic and they're apolitical and they have the energy to make a change, and that's great. Being a part of law, as a lawyer, practice before the Bombay High Court in civil and criminal and constitutional cases. And what I've realized is that through the courts, you can have massive impact on policy through constitutional law. Because what the court does is to enforce something called fundamental rights that are enshrined in our constitution, that everybody gets, and if the state violates these rights, you can enforce them in a court of law. The courts have massive powers in that jurisdiction. They can pass almost any kind of order, and most of the time they can just strike down law if it's unconstitutional and if it offends our right to privacy. Like 66A, I'm sure some of you remember, there was a section called 66A, part of the Information Technology Act, that prohibited objectionable content on the internet, which was being used by the ruling government to arrest children who express views that were controversial. So you can definitely move courts to affect genuine social changes and impact policy intelligently. And I think that the think tanks offer to file petitions on people's behalf who come across with ideas to impact policy. With courts are activists in our country, they definitely take notice of such petitions and they rule on them. Apart from that, I would just like to say that thank you for having me on, and I hope that I could also contribute effectively to this think tank. Thank you so much.
Indeed, time for us to hear from the very dynamic personality who is amidst all of us, ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Sanjay Singh. It's time to hear from you as well, sir.
हैं जो छोटे शहरों के टैलेंट थे उनको दिखाया है उनके इनोवेशन वो लोग कैसे इम्पैक्ट कर रहे हैं सिंगल पर्सन इंडिविजुअल्स या ग्रुप के तौर पे, वो सब दिखाते हैं। तो इस काफी तरह के चीजें इस तरह की फैली हुई है। फॉर एग्जाम्पल नॉर्दर्न इंडिया में एक शब्द इस्तेमाल होता है जुगाड़, उसको स्लैंग के तौर पे अब इस्तेमाल करने लगे, लेकिन वो अपने आप में एक टेक्नोलॉजी का इनोवेशन होता है जिसमें छोटी मोटी दो अलग अलग टेक्नोलॉजी को मिलाकर काम चलाओ टेक्नोलॉजी बनाई जाती है और वो सस्ते में लोग उसका इस्तेमाल करते हैं। जैसे बाइक था, बाइक के साथ किसी ने अपना रिक्शा जोड़ लिया और उसने उसको बना लिया। इस तरह की चीजें करने वाले छोटे शहरों में हमको बहुत ज्यादा लोग मिल जाते हैं, उस तरह के तमाम लोग हैं जिसके लिए एक प्लेटफॉर्म के तौर पर काम करें। और दूसरा एक और होगा कि एक चीज का आपको ख्याल रखना होगा मैं कि ये सिर्फ एक आम केयर इंटेलेक्चुअल्स जो होते हैं उनका प्लेटफॉर्म बन के न रह जाए, ग्रेजुअली आपको एक इंटरफेस ह्यूमन का रखना बहुत जरूरी है। क्योंकि सोशल मीडिया वगैरह हम बात करते हैं कि मेन स्ट्रीम जो मीडिया है टेलीविजन न्यूज़पेपर और बाकी रेडियो वगैरह ये चीजें हैं, लेकिन सोशल मीडिया अपने आप में अलग चल रहा है। बट काफी हद तक अब सोशल मीडिया भी मैनेज होने लगा है, सोशल मीडिया पे बाकायदा चीजें ट्रेंड कराई जाती है। तो सिर्फ इंटरनेट और डिजिटल के अलावा एक ह्यूमन इंटरफेस आप लोग रखें और उसको ग्रेजुअली जितना ज्यादा आप इंक्रीज कर सकेंगे इस तरह का प्लेटफॉर्म उनके लिए और बेहतर होता जाएगा। जो स्कैटर्ड टैलेंट है देश में उसको आप एक साथ में ला सकते हैं। ये दो चीजों का आपको मुख्य तौर पे ख्याल रखना पड़ेगा। और आखिर में चूंकि मैं न्यूज चैनल से हूँ, कोई ना कोई एक्सक्लूसिव खबर दिए बिना जाना मेरे से बहुत मुश्किल है, तो एक तमाम थिंक टैंक की मैं बात करता हूँ, लेकिन एक्चुअली में इस थिंक टैंक के पीछे भी एक थिंक टैंक है। मेरे दोस्त हैं डॉक्टर राजेंद्र प्रताप सिंह, ये अमेरिका के थिंक टैंक है, मिस्टर देशमुख का थिंक टैंक है, और शायद इस ऑडिटोरियम में मैं अकेला हूँ जिन्होंने फादर और सन दोनों को स्कूल जाते हुए देखा है, और सेम एज में मैंने देखा है। उनके साथ मैं स्कूल जाया करता था तब से देखा है, अमेर को मैंने देखा है छोटे से बड़े ग्रो होते हुए देखा है। तो इन लोगों का जो बेसिकली थॉट प्रोसेस था, डॉक्टर सिंह एक इंस्पिरेशन के तौर पे हमेशा काम करते रहे हैं, और मतलब मेरे जैसे कई सारे लोगों को उनके जो मित्र हैं उनको उन्होंने इंस्पायर किया है। आई एम श्योर कि ये वही वो पेड़ है जिसके ऊपर ये फल लगा हुआ है। एक जबरदस्त तालियां मैं चाहूंगा डॉक्टर सिंह के लिए आप लोगों। थैंक यू।
यू स्पोक अबाउट स्टूडेंट्स कमिंग टुगेदर फॉर सोशल मूवमेंट्स, वी कैन साइन पेटिशंस, सो हाउ डज इट मूव ऑन फ्रॉम देयर? लाइक फ्रॉम पेटिशन साइनिंग, से वी हैव 300 पेटिशन साइंड, हाउ डू वी गो अहेड फ्रॉम दैट?
So I'm going to give you an example. We've already done a bit of work before this organization started. We've made a policy proposal for changes in the People with Disabilities Act of 1995. So it's an act that deals with the specially abled section of our society, which is why the band was invited to create sensitization amongst the people. So certain parts of this provision that need immediate implementation will be sent to the judiciary in the form of a PIA. So this great democratic power that I think, as Mr. Bobde pointed out, is that you can file a petition, and the scenario of judicial activism in our country enables us, gives us that power to leapfrog the legislature and create the change that we want today. So for example, a petition that is signed by that, and especially one that is signed by a huge student population, says that it speaks for it. And that kind of a petition, if it reaches the court, can make a multitude of changes. So the process basically is that you file it in the court, then the case goes forward, and then hopefully it gets passed through, and then we can have the changes that we want.
All right, so well, that's one query sorted as well. Now before we march ahead to our next, can we have a round of applause as well to thank Neha for joining us?
मुझे लगता है कि बहुत ही अच्छा इनिशिएटिव है। जितने भी यंगस्टर्स हैं आज की तारीख में इंडिया में तकरीबन 65% यूथ हैं, मुझे लगता है कि अगर वो लोग एक दूसरे का हाथ थाम लें, यू नो ऐसे प्लेटफॉर्म्स हों जहाँ पर वो लोग साथ में आ सकें, तो आई थिंक बहुत बड़ा बदलाव बहुत जल्द आ सकता है हमारे देश में। एंड मैं इस तरह के इनिशिएटिव्स को ज़रूर सपोर्ट करता हूँ। आई रियली वांट द यंगस्टर्स टू कम फॉरवर्ड एंड टेक द चार्ज, बिकॉज दे आर रनिंग द कंट्री लिटरली। हाँ, जैसे आप कॉलेज में घुसते हो आपको प्रिंसिपल का रूम दिखता है, आपको यू नो लेक्चर रूम दिखते हैं, तो आपको बहुत सारी यादें आती हैं एंड सडनली आप उस जोन में चले जाते हैं अपने कॉलेज वाले डेज़ में. तो बहुत सारी यादें हैं ऑफकोर्स, लेकिन मैं शेयर नहीं करना चाहूँगा इस समय. यू नो कॉलेज के दिन सबसे ज़्यादा खूबसूरत दिन होते हैं सब आपकी लाइफ के, वो आप चाहें भी तो आप उन्हें नहीं भुला सकते हैं. कॉलेज की दोस्ती जो होती है वो हमेशा ज़िंदगी में चलती है. आज भी मेरे जो बेस्ट फ्रेंड्स हैं वो मेरे कॉलेज से हैं. सो आई थिंक इट्स अ ब्यूटिफुल टाइम एंड आप उसे याद करते ही हैं जब आप किसी कॉलेज में आते हैं. तो एक ख्याल तो बहुत बार आता था कि मैं भी बदलाव लेकर आऊँ, यू नो, लेकिन आपके पास में सोर्सेज नहीं थे, आपके पास एवेन्यूज नहीं थे, आपके पास में एक्सपोजर नहीं था, आपके साथ में यू नो आपको लगता था कि आप अकेले हैं, आपको लगता था कि कोई जुड़ेगा कि नहीं जुड़ेगा, आपको लगता था कि बहुत बड़ा काम है, मैं कैसे लोगों को कन्विंस करूँ, कैसे बाकी स्टूडेंट्स को कन्विंस करूँ. आज की तारीख में आई थिंक जब सोशल मीडिया है, आपके बाकी प्लेटफॉर्म्स हैं, यू नो आप ट्विटर पे जाएं, फेसबुक पे जाएं, एक एक करके सब लोग आपके साथ जुड़ने लगते हैं. यू नो आपका अगर आपके पास में कोई ख्याल है, आपके पास में कोई आइडिया है, सो आपको अप्रिसिएशन मिलता है, आपको सपोर्ट मिलता है, आपके पास एक्चुअल में पावर है कि आप कुछ कर सकें, आप बदलाव ला सकें, जो उस समय नहीं था आज से 15 साल पहले. लेकिन यू नो आज आप जो सोचते हैं वो आप करने की ताकत भी रखते हैं. फीवर की प्रमोशन अभी शुरू हो जाएंगी. आज मैं कॉलेज में अपनी फिल्म को प्रमोट करने के लिए नहीं आया था, या नहीं करने के इरादे से आया था मैं. जी हाँ, अगले महीने रिलीज़ हो रही है, बहुत जल्द आपको सब जगह देखने को मिलेगा. जो हमारा ट्रेलर रिलीज हुआ है उसका एक बहुत ही बहुत अच्छा, बहुत पॉजिटिव रिस्पॉन्स रहा है. आई होप कि ये रिस्पॉन्स बढ़ता जाए एंड पीपल इन्जॉय द फिल्म व्हेन इट रिलीजेस.
लेट हो रहा सुन मेरी बात.
First of all, I love this event because it was organized by this Young Bharatiya Foundation and a very young fellow. There are two young fellows like Amaya Pratap Singh and Abhishek. So they both have come up with the new platform that is called Think Tank, when you can actually put across your ideas, your confusions, your problems. And what they actually do is they do the brainstorming and they come up with the solutions. They come up with the new ideas to give the new perspective and the new angles to all the problems and solutions. I mean this college is the most wonderful memories of everybody's life, you know. So I still remember when I was in college, I was it was like the most important phase of my life. I can still remember all the activities which I was used to do in my college, and I can say that I got my life over there, because that was the time, that was the place where actually I could identify myself, who am I and why I want to pursue this career acting. So yeah, that was the turning point of my life when I joined my college and I actually got my I discovered myself over there. Of course, I said the same thing on stage as well. When I was in college, I had lot many ideas. Same thing, I had lot many confusions as well. But I had nobody to guide me. I had nobody to listen to me, you know. So, but today, because I come from Gujarat and that to a small town called Gandhinagar, where this kind of platforms are not so popular, and this kind of events when you can actually you know encourage the youth to speak up, that's not in much in demand. So yeah, it's very important to listen to the voice of this youth, this generation, and I'm glad that they have created this platform and today's youth have that opportunity to raise their voice and to ask a question. I just finished one film, its name is Carry On Kesar, which is going to release soon, and apart from that I have two major projects and the dates are going to be somewhere in September, so they might go on floor by in the second half of this year, and I have signed an NDA, so I am not able to say anything about the project more.
It's a social issue-based film, and I play a fashion designer coming from Paris and seeing the society's problem in a different way. And it's the same thing that how today's generation, people just think that today's generation is clueless, they don't know how to handle the life and how to handle the problems. But yes, we are in such a phase that we know how to handle our problems and how to come up with a different angle and a different solution. So this girl, there is a social issue involved in the film, and how this girl turns the mindset of an elderly couple and how their life gets changed. And while doing that, her own life gets changed. Yes. No, I don't go for the image. I really want to go for the subject, the content which matters for me, you know, because as an actor, I'm open for all kind of roles which I can perform, where I can show my acting skills and strength. So Calendar Girl was a different subject. Carry On Case is a completely different subject. You can't compare these two subjects. And as far as the glamour is concerned, so yes, it's a part of today's lifestyle, because if you see a college girl or if you see a CEO working in a multinational company, they have their own standard of glamour in their life. So yeah, when I represent the youth, when I represent the today's society on the silver screen, then it's somewhere it's connected, the glamour is connected in that. So it depends what kind of subject you are working on. It's totally de-glam, yeah, actually. Of course, I would love to. I have done a short film called Gulabi where I literally play a very de-glam role. So, but again, it's all about the subject which appeals the audience, not the character or the look of the character, you know. Yeah. No, not at all. Welcome.